went crazy.
What's going on, YouTube? This is J. Xavier Sports, and today we're going to be discussing Dante Fowler possibly getting traded from the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, will the Jaguars actually trade Dante Fowler is the question. Now, there's an article that suggests the Bears could trade for the elite pass rusher, and that Dante Fowler, according to Brad Biggs of the Chicago Tribune, could possibly be a target that the Bears could be, you know, deciding on whether or not they should be targeting an elite pass rusher. And one guy that Brad Biggs of the Chicago Tribune suggests is Dante Fowler of the Jaguars. Now, we see the Bears, you know, they could trade for a pass rusher. You know, as I just said, they got Allen Robinson from free agency from the Jaguars. So they have a little bit of familiarity as far as transactions with our players. So maybe they take a look at Dante Fowler. But from the Jaguars standpoint, when you look at Dante Fowler, he was a number 3 overall pick for the Jaguars in 2015. And you see this offseason, we declined to pick up his fifth-year option, which would make him a free agent at the end of the season. Now, if you take a look back at it, he tore his ACL in his first year in 2015. You know, his first ever exercise or a first ever drill, he tore his ACL. So that was very unfortunate. So he had to sit out a full season. Then in 2016, he collected 4 sacks. You know, he showed flashes here and there, but last season was really somewhat of his breakout year. And he had a pretty decent performance. He finished the season with 8 sacks and even sacked Tom Brady a couple times in the AFC Championship game. So we see the ability, we see the spurts, we see the flashes. So we know that he's a very talented player, and most likely, I mean, when you look at it, when you look at the Jaguars roster from top to bottom, he's most likely going to be one of our top 10 most coveted players on our roster, and probably one of our top 10 guys on our roster, period. So it really is a big deal whether or not we should trade him, keep him, or re-sign him, because what the Jaguars did in the offseason, usually when you decline fifth-year options, that usually means 2 things. One, you know, they want Dante Fowler to prove that he's worthy of his fifth year. So he will have to go out there and prove that he's worthy of having a long-term deal or a long-term contract, as we, you know, as you saw the Jaguars did with Bortles when they declined to pick up his option, and you saw how well he performed, and now they gave him like a 3-year extension. So you can kind of see that as being the blueprint for Dante Fowler. But like I said, if they don't really see him that much value in him, then they could trade him, you know, if another team sees that he's valuable to their roster. And I don't think the Jaguars are just going to dump him for anything. You know, like I said, if they feel like Dante Fowler will walk after this season and he has a great season, then, you know, there should be no reason why we don't try to make a trade, you know, at this point. But like I said, the Jaguars do feel like he's a viable piece to what we're trying to do and what we're trying to build. And, yeah, by all means, you definitely bring him back in. But I think this is an underrated storyline because, just like I said, if we choose to walk and he goes to another team and succeeds, which that tends to happen, you know, a lot with former Jaguar players, then, you know, like I said, we should at least get some value in return for him. So I thought that was a very intriguing article when I read it. So it's going to be interesting to see, you know, what decisions we make on Dante Fowler. But I think when you look at it, most likely he might not be back on the team after next season. But who knows? It just depends on, like I said, how much the Jaguars value him. And, you know, Dante Fowler could have a breakout season this year, and it may be better if we just resign him to a longer deal, especially, you know, if he starts to perform well in the start of the season and he leaves a good taste in our mouths. So I feel like, you know, like I said, he probably won't be back on the team because of how many other guys we have to take care of as well. And if other teams are covering him as possibly, you know, trading for him, then, you know, let's see what kind of value we can get in return for him. So, but overall, I think our defense will still be the best in the NFL next year. It'll still be tops. And I'm not at all worried about if we do lose him. You see, we selected Taven Bryan in the first round of the NFL draft. So they're going to continue to make the defensive line a point of emphasis as far as keep building that position and making it better. Like I said, you know, I've seen guys on TV, especially like picking the Texans or Titans to win the division this year. But, you know, I still feel like we're the team to beat. We still got the best defense, like I said, and you know, guys like Deshaun Watson and Andrew Luck, you know, we're going to be going after guys like that, and they have to show us respect, you know what I'm saying? So, period, end of discussion, you know, we're the teams to beat, and those teams are chasing us, you know. So, you know, it just feels good to have, you know, the best roster in the AFC South and kind of running things. Seems like we're going to be the kings of the AFC South here for years to come. But, yeah, I just wanted to bring this to you guys' attention. Like I said, I still feel like we're an elite defense without Dante Fowler, but definitely we did draft him. So we obviously want to maintain some of our draft picks at least, especially with him being a number 3 overall pick. So as the season goes on and as the trade deadline gets close during the middle of the season, we'll see if the Jaguars will make a move on Dante Fowler. But that's all I got for you guys today. Definitely check out my videos. Definitely like and subscribe. If it's your first time listening or watching, I do appreciate it. Definitely do, like I said, appreciate all the subscribers subscribing to me. All right, this is Jake Xavier Sports signing off. Go Jags!